Mr. Ang Boon Hyung, CEO Temasek Foundation, Excellency Ambassador Anil Kumar Nayar, Excellency Ambassador Suryo Pratomo, Mas Tommy, my dearest friend, Mas Sarwono Kusuma Atmaja, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. It gives me a great pleasure to be with you all on the occasion of the book discussion on Mas Sarwono's memoir, Steering a Middle Course from Activist to Secretary General of Golkar, as well as the second segment of today's agenda with the theme Climate Action. I share the hope of Temasek Foundation that the book discussion can provide context for better understanding of leadership disposition for the youth of today through Mas Sarwono's experiences. I would also like to congratulate Temasek Foundation for organizing this event in the midst of uncertainties due to acceleration of climate change, the seemingly erratic and unnerving development of COVID-19 pandemic, and the massive disruption to the economies of many nations. Temasek Foundation Shophouse Conversation continue to proceed in this difficult of challenging time, a testimony to a faith in the future to seek solutions. I also wish to underline the fact that Mas Sarwono's memoir was translated and published by Isaias Yusof Ishak Institute, a well-known and prestigious research organization. I would also like to acknowledge the foreword by Senior Minister for the National Security Singapore, Mr. Teo Chi Hang. I learned that during the nightmare years of 1997-1998, when our region was enveloped in thick haze brought about by massive forest and bushfire, Mr. Teo Chi Hang, as Minister of Environment, sent a team of young staffers from National Environment Agency to work alongside Indonesia's personnel from Babeda to monitor, evaluate, and mitigate the disaster. Such an empathy bodes well to the future cooperation between Indonesia and Singapore. Hopefully, the event of today will enhance mutually beneficial relationship based on shared values and priorities. Excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, let me now enlighten you all on my own personal experience with Mas Sarwono. He was the Secretary General of Golkar when we met for the first time, while I was at the beginning for my career as a civil servant, as well as a youth activist in Lampung province in the southern tip of Sumatra. We, the young people at that time, were all impressed with his ability to analyze and explain the complexities of politics with clear and simple language punctuated by his wit and dry humor. He was able to make sense of the tortuous Golkar pathway towards the political party of the future, able to compete with new political parties whose names we don't know yet. As he once said in quoting Pak Harto's strategy, in preparing for the post-Suharto era, Mas Sarwono's memoir has conveyed messages which are worthy of note, such as, first, he was brought up in a family which upheld strong ethical values, practiced inclusivity and nurtured care for others. Second, he showed tremendous determination to overcome his weaknesses. Sure, he had a healthy curiosity and willingness to take risks and manage those risks until they were turned into opportunities. I am convinced that Mas Sarwono will explain further in the panel discussion his adventures as he went through the heyday of the new order, beginning as an activist and later becoming the Secretary General of Golkar, the first civilian to sit in that position. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, permit me now to address matters related to the second segment of this event, namely climate action. In pursuing climate change policies, the Ministry of Environment and Forestry is guided by two basic approaches. The first approach is to continuously improve our performance through corrective actions. The second approach is to aim for policy coherence. Embarking from the above approaches, our climate actions are aimed to strengthen climate adaptation and mitigation measures simultaneously and on an even footing so as achieve climate resilience. I also see great merit of collaborative approach in whatever we do. Partnerships are an essential component of our efforts. Many important measures have been carried out in cooperation with other line ministries, local government, and local entities, as well as in collaboration with various international development partners, all related to challenges in promoting sustainable forest management. I'm lucky that I have Mas Sarwono leading the National Advisory Board on Climate Change Policy to provide advice for the Ministry of Environment and Forestry as the national focal point of UNFCCC. The period of 2015 to 2020 has been a period of fundamental change, during which deforestation and forest fire have been significantly reduced, and an extensive forest rehabilitation, including peatland and mangrove restoration, have been intensified through a new collaborative approach synergizing the government, private sectors, and communities. During the 5 years of President Joko Widodo's administration, incidents of forest and land fires has been significantly reduced from 2.611 million hectares in 2015 to 328,000 hectares in 2019. The number for the year of 2020 is 296,000 hectares, which is consistent with the trend shown for earlier years. We are determined to reduce the incidence even further in the years to come, employing all means possible, including weather modification technique through cloud seeding, various technological tools to monitor, report, and verify, and concerted collaborative effort to preventing and mitigating fires. The reduction of forest and land fire has paved the way to augment sustainable livelihoods in the production of life essentials, as well as the sustainable management of peatland. Conservation of peatland is a strategic issue due to the uniqueness of peatland domes as huge reservoirs of water and for its rich biodiversity. Indonesia is also determined to do more in conserving and rehabilitating mangrove forests, which play a vital role in protecting our coastline as well as in preserving coastal biodiversity. Mangrove forest conservation efforts up to now have been pioneered by coastal communities with support from government and civil society organizations. These pioneering efforts have to be augmented and strengthened. And in that sense, the Agency for Peatland and Mangrove Rehabilitation, BRGM, has been established to handle conservation and sustainable utilization of peatland and mangrove through protection and rehabilitation efforts in priority areas. Excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, our paradigm shift and continuous corrective actions in managing our environment and forest have resulted in a significant reduction on CO2 emissions, leading to commitment by the Green Climate Fund, GCF, the Norwegian government and Forest Carbon Partnership Facilities, FCFF, and the Biocarbon Fund to make result-based payment to Indonesia. These payments are done according to the Red Plus scheme, which attests to Indonesia's success in reducing deforestation. The above is in line with our determination to embark on a low-carbon economy in which climate funding is an essential part. The result-based payment to be received by Indonesia is an initial step towards a comprehensive global trend in reshaping our economies and lifestyle. We should eventually lead to a zero-emission global society. Indonesia has begun in that direction by establishing the Agency for Environmental Fund Management, BPDLH. BPDLH is part of a comprehensive effort to reshape the institutional and regulatory architecture in preparation of a future that is going to be different to the age we are living in. Excellencies, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to reiterate the role of Mas Sarwono in this development. As an advisor on climate change policies, he is very much in the background, communicating and encouraging the younger generation in the Ministry of Environment and Forestry. It used to be different at the stage when the Ministry of Environment and Forestry was established in October 2014, which merged two ministries and other institutions. In the adhocracy in that year, Mas Sarwono and friends played a visible role as frontliners, including in preparing for UNFCCC conference in Paris. Such was the case as well as in the selection of senior officials in line with Civil Service Commission guideline. As soon as everything fell in place, he withdrew to the backstage, so to speak. Finally, I wish you all the best for the success of this Shophouse conversation. Stay healthy and safe. Thank you.